government search operations recover at least 39 bodies after the onslaught of Typhoon Ulysses, international name VAMCO. Armed Forces of the Philippines, or AFP Chief General Gilbert Gapay, says Friday, November 13, this is the total number of cadavers retrieved by search teams from the AFP, Philippine National Police, and the Bureau of Fire Protection in the regions affected by the typhoon. However, the official death toll from the NDRRMC is only 14. The military chief clarifies the retrieved bodies still need to be verified as to whether the deaths were indeed caused by the typhoon. He says at least 40 people are reported injured and at least 22 people are missing in different regions. Typhoon Ulysses sustained torrential rains prompt 200,000 people to evacuate preemptively, with almost 140,000 people rescued from being trapped by heavy floods. The Agriculture Department estimates the total damage in agriculture to around almost 979 million pesos, affecting over 51,200 hectares of agricultural land. Meantime, Mayor Marcelino Chedoro declares a state of calamity in Marikina City following floods brought by the typhoon. In an interview with Teleradio, Chedoro says under a state of calamity, not only can the government respond, but residents can also apply for emergency or calamity loans. The Marikina River water level rose to 22 meters Thursday, November 12, as Ulysses moved inland before dawn, surpassing the 21.5-meter level it reached during Tropical Storm Ondoy in 2009. Fans may be asked not to cheer at the Tokyo Olympics to avoid the risk of spreading the coronavirus. Tokyo 2020 Chief Executive Toshiro Muto says Thursday, November 12, officials are considering urging fans not to shout or talk loudly during the games to minimize the risk of COVID-19 infections. But Muto adds the practicality and feasibility of clamping down on cheering needs to be considered. Despite the safety precautions they are imposing, he says fans arriving in Japan may be spared a mandatory two-week quarantine, saying it will be too hard to enforce. The Olympics are postponed to next July because of the coronavirus pandemic. But despite a rising caseload worldwide, the outlook is brightening for the games. In the United States, major news groups declare presidential candidate Joe Biden's win in the state of Arizona, further cementing his lead in the Electoral College and flipping the state Democratic for the first time since 1996 in the elections won by Bill Clinton. NBC, CBS, ABC, and CNN declare Biden the winner in the tight race with a lead of more than 11,000 ballots, giving him the state's 11 electoral votes. Fox News and the Associated Press called the race in Biden's favor on election night, triggering the wrath of President Donald Trump. Arizona gives Biden a 290-217 lead over Trump in the Electoral College that ultimately decides the presidency, with 270 needed to win the White House. Despite Biden being declared winner of the election on Saturday, Trump refuses to concede and continues to make baseless claims of election fraud. Races in North Carolina and Georgia have yet to be called. Social media platform Twitter labels about 300,000 tweets related to the U.S. presidential election as potentially misleading. In a statement published Thursday, November 12, Twitter says the labels were issued between October 27 and November 11. Of the 300,000 flagged tweets, 456 were covered over by a warning message and had engagement features limited, where users could not like, retweet, or reply to the posts. Nearly half of outgoing U.S. President Donald Trump's tweets were flagged by Twitter in the days following the election. Trump claims without evidence that he won and the process was tainted by massive fraud. This particular video showing people rescued due to the onslaught of Typhoon Ulysses or VAMCO is false. Twitter user @SteffiGrande12 posted a video on the morning of Thursday, November 12, supposedly showing people being rescued from the roof. Using reverse image search, Rappler finds the video was taken in Guatemala and was posted on November 7 after Hurricane Eta battered Central America. It was tweeted by Guatemalan President Alejandro Giammattei with a caption that translates to, "We will continue with the rescue efforts of each family and each Guatemalan. United, we will emerge from this emergency." Typhoon Ulysses hit land in Quezon Province on Wednesday, November 11. As of Friday, November 13, it already left the Philippine area of responsibility.